soon as we start filming, everyone remembers they need something from the kitchen. But you're already used to this situation. What I'm making today? My absolute favorite summertime dish. I was gonna say green eggs and beans, but it's green beans and eggs. It's super delicious. I made it probably 2, 3, 4, 5 years ago. I don't remember. But this time, since I have these beautiful colored greens, we were at farmer's market yesterday, I'm thinking to incorporate this green, which is extremely healthy, but I should confess, it's not the easiest to eat. It's really tough, it has bitterness, but what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna slightly blanch this. I have boiling water, I'm gonna add a little bit salt. And oh, by the way, I have 2 pounds of green beans, fresh, organic, extremely healthy. I have 4 eggs, pasture raised, no cage, free chickens, happy, happy. And I have olive oil, a bit of butter, black pepper, what else? Oh, and I'll also use some garlic. You can't spoil a dish with garlic. So what I'm gonna start with, I'll salt some my water, and then I'll dip my leaves, not my leaves, collard greens, into hot water a few minutes, and then into ice cold water. I don't want to overcook them. I want to save their good qualities. Just like so. I wash them, by the way, if you're asking, if you're interested. A couple of this. I want to just mix it with the beans, saute, oh, onions. We also need 1 or 2 onions. I have shallots. They are milder and sweeter and more digestible. I'll use one beautiful head of shallot. Okay, let me just quickly give this a couple dips. And you know, we're gonna remove these ones, right? Very tough. So this is basically done. I don't want to continue cooking. And while the water is restarting to boil, I'm gonna slice my beans into bite-sized pieces. My mom would always slice them into this shape. You tell me how it's called. Diamond shape. All right, you don't have to slice them into diamond shapes. As long as you have them in bite size, you should be good. A few at a time. Finally, after an hour of chopping and slicing, this is ready. And I'm gonna cook this until it's not too soft, not too crispy, crunchy. I like the other kind of beans, the long and skinny beans. I call them skinny beans, and I call these flat beans. By the way, these are more richer and more deeper in taste. Try this if you haven't tried them. But if you're using these beans, they need to be cooked properly. To me, they don't taste as well when they're like crispy and undercooked. But the other kind tastes better when they're slightly just blanched. You know what I mean, right? So this I'm gonna cook to perfect, not too soft, not too crispy. I don't know how to explain it, and I don't know how many minutes. I'll let you know. I'll time it. For the first time in my life, I'm gonna time how long I cook my flat beans. All right. And I'll taste the salt. By the way, it's good to salt them already rather than adding the salt when they're sauteing. Okay, I'm gonna time it. I'll do 9 minutes and then I'll check. And while this is cooking, it's a good idea to start chopping or slicing the onions and try sauteing slowly and peacefully. Alright. Did I taste the salt? No, I didn't. Tasteless. Alright, I'll let this cook and I'll start my skillet. Start preheating the skillet and start slicing my onions. Easy peasy. And I'm sure I forgot to tell you that there is another important ingredient, herb, dill, or cilantro may work as well, but dill makes this dish absolutely delicious and more flavorful. So I'll go grab the dill as soon as I put these scallions into skillet. I ended up using two of them, which is four of them. They come in two packs. Small or large slices, it's up to you. I even have some blended onion in the fridge, but for some reason I want to use this fresh, never frozen or never used scallions. Alright, I'll make them coarse slices. And you may not believe this, but these never used brand new scallions made me so emotional. Alright, I had no idea they could be this spicy. So to this, hold on, I'll add these scallions to get rid of them. And then I'll add some olive oil, probably 2 tablespoons. And 1 tablespoon of butter. And I'll let this saute. And I'll add a bit of salt to this. Just a little bit. They're not ready yet. I checked. So while it's cooking, that's sauteing, I'll put the eggs, add some garlic to the eggs. 1 clove of garlic should be enough. A bit of salt, black pepper. And then I'll slice my... It's very heavy. I'll put this here. I'll slice my colored greens. Alright, we don't want to waste time. And these are such delicious eggs. From such beautiful chicken. Don't forget you're sauteing something on this side. It smells delicious. To this side, adding some pepper. A good amount of pepper, like 1/2 teaspoonful, and a clove of garlic. Mince it or squeeze it, anything you prefer. This is such a beautiful everything. Today's ingredients are super beautiful, super fresh, directly from farmer's market in Solvang. So nothing went to fridge except for the eggs so far. Alright, I'll squeeze it. Just like so. And a pinch of salt. You always want to salt your ingredients. And I forgot to bring the dill. Slightly splash, and that's normal. This is ready. I'm slicing my greens. I think I'll do Hold on, let me see. I'll remove this tough part. Is this too tough? No, okay, I can handle it. And then this one. And then I'll fold everything together. And do slices. It's 9 minutes. Hold on, let me see.
Okay.
9 minutes is the perfect time. This is ready. I'm gonna strain this, set aside, and we'll go ahead and continue. And it will go directly to that cold water, so it stops cooking. Alright, by the time I go and grab my special mittens, I'll use a towel, and I'll be very careful, I promise. It up and it's almost ready. I will lower the heat and continue with colored greens. I'm gonna roll this like so and slice it into strips, thin or thick, doesn't really matter. I just want these greens to be along with my green beans, like pair them. I'm thinking they'll pair perfectly. Yes, I haven't tried making this dish before, but that's how I normally cook. I go, I improvise. Alright, so the beans and already slightly blanched colored greens will go over our sautéed onions or shallots, both will work. And then I'll taste the salt, add the egg mixture. And it's done. And yes, I will not forget to add fresh dill at the very end. Okay. And I'll go get the beans. I'll cook this together like 3-4 minutes, not too long. It needs salt. Okay. Give it a quick stir. If you want to use some of your favorite spices, let's say whatever you prefer with beans, some cumin, curry, that will work. Spice it your way, always. This looks beautiful already, right? I'll taste it one more time. Some of this. Perfect. So good together. Got the super sweet cherry tomatoes. I'm thinking I'm gonna layer this over the egg mixture and let it slightly soften. My mom would always serve these green beans with eggs with lolikovachtsam, tomato salad. So delicious. Matches so well. Okay. I'm adding the eggs. I'm gonna turn this off because mine is electric stovetop, it still saves the heat for a while. Pour it over nicely, peacefully. Okay. Another tap, tap, tap. Oh, I forgot the deal. Hold on, don't go anywhere. (laughs) I'll give it a quick wash. Just a little bit. A little bit gives a good amount of flavor. You know, dill is pretty strong and aromatic herb, so don't underestimate the power of dill. I'll let this over, and then the tomatoes, and then close the lid. Let it get along for a few minutes, and then we can taste it. And if you find the eggs not cooked very well, feel free to restart your heat again. But as soon as I close the lid, the eggs will cook down perfectly. After 5 to 7 minutes, and I gave it a quick stir while it was sitting doing nothing. Look at this beauty. Aram, let's take pictures. And if you consider this as a breakfast, although this is a dinner dish for us, you can get a toast, nice slice of bread, toast it and pour this over and just serve it for breakfast. But yeah, this is dinner, excuse me, not breakfast. Incredibly delicious. Done with our photo session. Time to try. And I love with some extra virgin olive oil drizzle. It's super good for you and it's super delicious. Mm-hmm. Extra pepper. And of course a slice of bread. I eat everything with bread. Just a small slice, let's say. And a good amount of deliciousness. So good. I would also add some gallop of fresh cold yogurt. It will match so perfectly. Try it. I won't be writing a recipe for this. I had 2 pounds of beans, a few leaves of colored greens, can be 5 or 6 leaves, however you prefer. 4 eggs, could be 5 eggs, even better if you're egg lover. Shallots, 1, 2. It's simple recipe. I don't want you to stress over it. Just go ahead and make it. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you soon. And I'm so happy to be back. The tomatoes are so soft and tangy. And sweet.